Very good morning, children. Exercise 3.3. Last time I gave you all these six sums to be worked out. Do you remember? In which I have already shown the working of 5th, 6th and 4th, I suppose. Am I right? And so remaining three you had to work out on your own. So in this particular sum, you could have taken out the x value or y value from any one of this equation and substituted. I think this would be the easiest of the sum. I hope you must have got the answer. In the second sum, the second equation has to be simplified. So when you simplify, your second equation will be twice s after taking LCM. Twice s plus thrice t will be equal to 36, because the 6 LCM will be multiplied over here. So twice s plus thrice t is 36, and then you try to eliminate. So there you can take out the value of s or t from the first equation, that would be easier. In this particular third sum, I don't know how many of you understood, but in the third sum, if you observe, you can take out 3 common from the second equation. If you take 3 common, the equation will be reduced to 3x minus y equal to 3, which means both the equations will be exactly same. In such a situation, the equation cannot be solved. You say that there are infinite solutions. Remember, in the first video I had explained this. So this sum cannot be solved. You cannot find the answer for the third sum because both the equations are exactly same. When you take out 3 common from the second equation, the equations are exactly similar. So infinite solutions are there. So understood all these 6 sums? Okay. Now we continue further with the next question. What is the next question? Solve 2x plus 3y is 11 and this 2x minus 4y is minus 2, 24. You have to solve this equation first by substitution. That would be the easiest way. Any of this sum you have done, same method you will solve this. And then you get the x and y value which you have to substitute in this equation, y equal to mx plus 3, so that you can calculate the value of m. Let us see how we will do it. So the equation is twice x plus 3y is 11. 2x minus 4y is minus 24. You take out x value. I took it out from the first equation. 11 minus 3y whole divided by 2. Which I am going to put it in the second equation. So 2 times x. In place of x I have put the value of x. Minus 4y is minus 24. Then 11 minus 3y. This 2 you take LCM. There is no need to take LCM. Remember in the previous class I told you that if you have divisible terms like this, you can cancel it. So I cancel 2 and 2. So left out is 11 minus 3y minus 4y is minus 24, which gives me 11 minus 7y is minus 24. So minus 7y is minus 35, both negative. So therefore multiplying negative to both the sides, I will get y is equal to 5. Now this value I had to put it in the equation for finding value of x. So x is equal to 11 minus 3y upon 2 was the value which you had taken from the first one. In that I am putting the value of y 5, and if I solve it further I will get minus 2. So x value minus 2, y value 5. Now I have to put it where y is equal to mx plus 3. So if you substitute the values of y and x, you will get the value of m finally minus 1. So got the complete sum? Okay. Come on. Now the next question. What is the next question given over here? From the following pair of equations, you have to frame the equation and then you have to solve it. Okay? So how will you frame the equation now? The first question says, difference between two numbers is 26. One number is 3 times the other. Find them. So here, for problems you require statements. You will say let one number be x, so the other number would be y. Now their difference is given to 26. So difference of two numbers is 26, that is x minus y is 26. This is your first equation. Then it is mentioned that one number is 3 times the other. So any one of the number. So I will take x is 3 times y. So two equations I am having. Now here already I am having the value of x. This 3y I will put it over here. So x minus y is 26, the value of x is 3y, I am substituting, so 3y minus y is 26, 2y is 26, y is 13. Now this y value I will put it in x is equal to 3y, so I will get the value of x 39. So my numbers are 39 and 30. Got it? Next question. The larger of the two supplementary angles exceed the smaller by 18. Find them. What are supplementary angles? When two angles sum is 180, they are said to be supplementary of each other. So here the supposition will be, let one angle be x, then the other will definitely be 180 minus x, because both are supplementary. Now the difference they are saying, that is the larger one is greater than the smaller by 18. So this will be the larger, I am assuming. Larger greater than the smaller. So larger minus smaller. Because one is x, the other is 180 minus x. It can be x minus, x can also be larger. 180 minus x can also be larger. You cannot say which one. So here I have taken as 180 minus x is 18. So it will be 180 minus 18 is, this x goes on the other side, so twice x. So 162 is twice x, x is 81. So if one x, one value, one angle is 81, then the other angle will be 99. 180 minus the given value. Clear? So the angles are 81 and 99. The third sum which is given to you. Next question. Next question says, a coach of a cricket team is buying 7 bats and 6 balls for 3800. Later, she buys 3 bats and 5 balls for 1750. You have to find the cost of each bat and each ball. So here you have to assume the value of the bat and the ball. So let us move into this sum. Let the cost of one ball be x and the cost of one bat be rupee y. So for 7 bats it will be 7y and 6 balls will be 6x. Correct or not? Because ball is x costing and bat is y. So 7y plus 6x is total 3800. Similarly, the second equation would be, what was the second statement in the question? In the question it was 3 bats and 5 balls. So 3 bats and 5 balls, what will you do? 3y plus 5x is 1750. So you are having two equations now. Can you eliminate it and work it out? You will solve the equation on your own. I have just framed the equation for you. Solution part is left, that you have to complete it. You take value of x or y from any one of the equation and substitute in the other. I have given you enough of practice of substitution. So now after the equation is framed, it is to be solved. So please solve this equation and get the answer. The next question which is given to you is, the taxi charges in a city is fixed, partly is fixed, with the charge of the distance covered. Means some amount is fixed and the remaining amount varies according to the distance. If you are travelling 10 km, the charge will be 105, and for 15 km it is going to be 155. So what is the fixed charge and what is the charge per kilometer? These are the two things to be supposed. And then you compute how much will a person pay if he is travelling 25 kilometers. Got the question? Come on. Here you will say, let the fixed charge be rupees X and let the charge per kilometer be rupees Y. So if you are travelling a distance of 10 km and the expense is 105, you will write 105 amount where partly is fixed X and partly based on the 10 km. So Y is for 1 km, so for 10 km 10Y. So X plus 10Y is 105, total cost. Second statement given is, for 15 km is 155. So 15 km means 15Y will be total amount and X is partly fixed. So X plus 15Y will be 155. Again you got two equations. Can you solve it? Now here no need of multi. Here you can directly take out the value of X from here, first equation, and put it over here in the second one. Or take it out from here and put it in the first one. And then solve it. So both these equations are not completely solved. You will have to solve it. I have framed the equation for you. Okay. Next one. A fraction becomes 9 by 11. If 2 is added both to the numerator and the denominator, and if 3 is added to both the numerator and denominator, it will become 5 by 6. Find the fraction. Now in a fraction, you always have a numerator and denominator. So here your duty is to suppose them. Let the numerator be x and the denominator be y in a fraction. So your original fraction will be x upon y. Now the first statement says, if 2 is added to both numerator and denominator, the fraction becomes 9 by 11. So You are adding 2 to the numerator, you are adding 2 to the denominator, the fraction becomes 9 by 11. Second statement given is 3 is added to both the numerator and denominator. So x plus 3, y plus 3, and the fraction becomes 5 by 6. Now this one I have already solved it for you. Because in the previous two cases there were no fractions, they were simple ones, so I asked you to solve it. But in this case, since there is a fractional part, I have explained it further. So you cross multiply, 11x plus 22 will be 9y plus 18. And then you get an equation reduced to 11x minus 9y is minus 4. In this part, 6x plus 18 is 5y plus 15. So this will be reduced to 6x minus 5y is minus 3. Now you take the value of x from any one of them. I have taken it off from here. X is equal to minus 4 plus 9y whole upon 11. And this value I am going to put it over here. So 6 times x.